Kasha ba?
Goodbye, stock wheels.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another vlog. Before everything else, magpapa giveaway muna tayo.
Nice.
So, ito siya, guys. This is a D-pillar trim from Otoproject. It actually makes it gloss black, itong area na to. So, nakapatong lang siya. And if you take a look at yung likod nito, double-sided tape lang yung kailangan nilagay dito. But anyway, we've decided to let it go na lang kasi I think some people like it din. So, imbis na ikakabit namin kay Project Raize, we're gonna give this away. So, just comment down below if you want to join the giveaway. Just comment, D-pillar trim for me. Oh, yun. So, just comment that down below and then I'm gonna pick a random winner within a few weeks and then, yun, congrats sa'yo. Just pay for the shipping na lang papunta sa inyo. Okay, so now that you know the giveaway, next is the big part of this vlog, which is probably the wheel reveal. So wheel reveal in 3, 2, 1, go! Finger clearance. So here it is, guys, Project Raize with the new wheels and tires. So let's get into it real quick. So switch lang tayo sa zoomed in view para mas malinaw. And you can see here, iba na yung tires. First, it says here Open Country because these are the Toyo Open Country RT tires. RT meaning rugged terrain. Itong tires na to are actually 215/70/16s. Compared to the stock one, it's actually 15 millimeters taller over here and 15 millimeters taller over here. So if you think about it, umangat pa yung total ground clearance ng car by 15 millimeters just because of how large these tires. One thing to note here is that hindi nyo pwede ikabit tong tires, guys, kapag hindi naka-lift yung Raize ninyo. So as you know, in our previous vlogs, we lifted Project Raize by around 1.1 to 1.2 inches front and back. So ito yung perfect wheel and tire setup for a lifted Raize. So anyway, we downgraded to 16s para lumiit yung wheels kasi 17s yung stock, diba? 16s na siya para maging super kapal tong tire profile na to. And okay yan para sa trail or light off-roading or overlanding. And then yun, let's go to the wheels. So as you can see, guys, ito yung new wheels natin. Yung brand ng wheels na to is actually MLJ. It's a Japanese brand, pero actually made in China siya. Pero for a made in China product, it's a very good quality wheel. This wheel is actually not something na, you know, yung tinatry lang namin. Subok na to sa Japan because other Raize overlanders sa Japan actually use this wheel. And the model is actually the XJ04. 4x100 siya. It was very hard to find off-road looking wheels na 4x100 kasi konti lang naman talaga yung ganun. And then ito yung center cap niya. And as you can see, it's blank here kasi hindi pa namin kinakabit yung parang sticker dyan. Xtreme-J yung nakasulat. Anyway, guys, let me know in the comment section below what you think of these new wheels and tires. So talagang parang overland ready na talaga si Project Raize. So we got the lift, we got the chunky meaty tires, we got proper wheels that look really good. Oh, yan, oh, ganda.
Laki ng tinangkad.
From a mathematical perspective, 1.1 inch lift plus 15 millimeters pa from the tires. So, ganun kalaki yung tinangkad ng car.
Mas matangkad na yata sa akin yung...
Yeah, mas matangkad na yung Raize kaysa sa sayo ngayon. Kasi nung stock, mas mababa siya eh. So, for those who are wondering, this is actually a 16x6.5 wheel, whereas the stock one was 17x6. In terms of offset naman, yung stock was plus 40, ito naman plus 38. So far, ito yung favorite angle ko, guys, yung likod, tapos itong wheel and tire. Kasi I don't know, there's something about the symmetry dito sa likod with this wheel and tire plus the lift. Parang ang ganda niya tingnan. Yung front kasi medyo may parang off sa front eh, no? Pero ayan siya. Overall, it looks really good. Parang from this angle mukha siyang Forester. So, in terms of clearance naman, guys, papakita namin sa inyo how tight the clearance is. So my dad was gonna turn the wheel to the right, and I'm gonna show you an area of concern kasi baka magtaka kayo, hindi ba sa sayad? Sige, go, turn. All the way. Yan, so ganyan yung clearance niya. And so far guys, I've been driving kanina pa and wala naman nagro-rub. Yan, so this is turned all the way. And meron, may space pa dun. Walang problema in terms of clearance. Medyo masikip lang, but this is really the biggest tire that you can fit on the Toyota Raize. And of course, kailangan naka-lift ka. So pakabila naman all the way, wala talagang clearance issues dito. Everything is clear. And dito naman, I want to show this to you guys. Ito yung strut and ito yung tire. There's also some space pa here. You can still add negative camber actually. Pero right now, my pinky still fits. So, goods pa yan. Pwede pa yan lagyan ng negative camber if I want to. This is really the perfect wheel and tire combo. The biggest one actually that you can fit on the Raize na naka-lift ng 1.1 inch. So, yun. In terms of finish pala guys ng wheels, this area over here is actually parang brushed, ano siya, brushed gunmetal. Itong part na to, na pinatungan ng gloss. So, yan. Tapos ito, this is gloss black. And then meron siyang parang mukha siyang beadlock eh, no? Pero design lang to honestly. Pero these bolts are real. As in, pwede mo siya tanggalin talaga. You unscrew it and you can take it off.
Isa pang color option ito na all black.
Yeah, so actually, the story here is that we were supposed to get the all black one. Pero sabi ko sa dad ko, pag kinuha natin yung all black, magiging sobrang itim na tong area na to. Itim na ngayon tire, itim na yung cladding. So pag all black pa yan, itim na talaga lahat, wala na tayong makita. So this one gave a good contrast kasi meron parang gunmetal ewan dito. Tapos may mga, yan, yung chrome na bolts around it. Actually, what I like about this wheel talaga is, biglang nabagayan niya itong chrome door handle. Kasi dati itong chrome door handle didn't match anything with the car. So now that we have something medyo silver and shiny, at least now it somehow matches. Do you get what I mean? Parang ngayon, no? Nagmamatch na yung look ngayon. So, may binabagayan na yung mga parts ng car. If you want to get these wheels, you can order it in Peter's Garage on Facebook. That's my dad's page. And the link is in the description box below. So, PM is key lang. And you can get yourself this set.
Tatapat natin ganyan.
So, yan. Nakakabit na, guys. And gitna na siya. Yan. So, actually, dapat pag ganito siya. Yan, ganyan. Tara! So, mas complete na yung itsura niya. So guys, ito yung nahanap ng dad ko sa Shopee. Actually, my dad was selling this product, pero meron na pala sa Shopee. So, we're gonna link this down below. This is actually hub-centric rings na made out of aluminum. Similar to yung sa kinabit ko sa GR Yaris. And this is actually for the Raize, specifically for these wheels. Kasi ito, actually sa likod ng center cap, hindi mo makikita. Hindi pa siya hub-centric. So, you need this para mawala yung space in between the wheel and the center bore. So when you put that sa likod, at least supported yung ano, yung bolts sa lug nuts, hindi sila stressed masyado pag naaalog yung wheel or something. So yeah, hub-centric rings. Not gonna show it anymore kasi pag kinabit ko hindi niya rin naman makikita. It's gonna be behind that. So yun lang, pinakita lang namin. If you wanna order this, available to sa Shopee and the link is in the description box below.
Ang size ng gulong nito pareho sa size ng gulong ng Jimny.
So this is 21570 na BF Goodrich all-terrain. Ito yung mas grabe kasi all-terrain. Pero 21570 siya. And can you believe it? Yan din yung nilagay sa Raize. 21570. But this is only rugged terrain, not all-terrain. So hindi siya kasing wild. Yung tread niya is not as wild. The funny story actually is that itong tires na to guys is supposed to be for my dad's project jeepney. So, binili niya yan kasi dapat daw, ito yung ipapang-trail niya na gulong and lalagyan niya ng parang wheelset na pang bakbak lang. Pero when we found out na, oh, ito rin pala yung tire na kailangan natin when we build Project Raize, eh, yun na lang inilagay dito. So, sakto siya, rugged terrain lang, not all terrain. Kasi nga, you guys know naman, the Raize is just a front-wheel drive car. And it's not four-wheel drive, it's not gonna do anything crazy. Pang light trail lang talaga siya, nothing wild. So, sakto lang tong rugged terrain.
Nakatapos lang ng malakas na ulan, eksakto, meron tayong part para dyan. JDM to na rain visor.
Ah, so hindi siya yung Shopee.
Hindi Shopee, hindi yung Otoproject. Kasi kadalasan makikita mo yung mga rain visor may nalagay pa Raize, di ba?
Oh, medyo baduy nga.
Akala mo naman mawawala yun. Hindi naman.
Anyway, so JDM to.
JDM.
OEM? Or hindi?
Hindi OEM. Actually, ang Toyota may OEM siya.
Oh.
Pangit.
Bakit?
Kasi solid black ang kulay.
Ingay maganda eh.
Hindi.
Oh, para mag-match siya with the ano, the roof line para maging concealed.
Hindi eh paano yung mga hindi naka-black?
Oh, tingnan natin kung maganda.
Oo.
Medyo so, parang dark so, gray nga siya,
no. Kulay.
Parang tinted
light,
siya.
Light smoke.
Oh, parang dark gray nga yung itsura.
Light gray, hindi dark.
Ha? Light gray ba yan?
Kitang-kita yung kamay ko.
Ah, sabagay. Yes. Oo. Apart from yung double-sided tape na pang-support, meron siyang mga butas. Ayan, may butas siya dito. Kasi may mga clip to kasama to actually make the hold permanent and very strong. And the nice part is that hindi siya tulad ng mga cheap na rain visor. Meron siya talagang parang ano dito, rubber to prevent water from actually passing through. Talagang pinag-isipan nila yung design nito. So this is from Japan. Ano ba yung brand nito?
Nasa link lang sa baba.
Ha? So guys, the rain visors come with these parts and ito yung mga pinaka-important na part, itong mga clip na to, which differentiates this rain visor from a regular rain visor na naka-double tape lang. It's because ganito siya. Yeah, so you just pull that down which exposes the frame.
Ito, papasok mo lang dyan.
Yan. Isusok-sok mo lang dyan.
Lang, babalik mo lang.
Yan.
Ayan na.
So when you put the rain visor on top, mag-a-align siya dyan sa butas na yan. And then, dyan papasok yung itong mga clip na to. As you can see, yung sa Type R, yan. Ganyan din siya. May parang clip siya. Pinindot mo yung clip na yan. Mag-e-expand siya dito sa likod. Inside the rubber. So basically, maiipit na yung metal clip na to. And as a result, magiging super sturdy na yung pagkahawak niya sa rain visor.
A few moments later.
Here is the final product, guys. We have successfully installed these rain visors. And sobrang sturdy na niya kasi naka-clip siya. If you wanna order this part, link is in the description box naman for Peter's Garage PH. That's my dad's page. And PM is key. So, yan. Pwede nyo i-order niyan. So from the inside, yan. That's
medyo
what
wala ng araw yan, ha?
Yeah, wala na masyadong araw. And as you can see, hindi siya sobrang dark. Yan, para kang nakatint lang. So, yan. Very usable pa rin yung buong window. So guys, that's it for this vlog and I hope you guys enjoyed. Meron na siyang pang off-road talaga na wheels and tires. And at the same time, may rain visors na din siya. Perfect for the rainy season nowadays. So, ayun. Project Raize build continues. Abangan na lang kung ano yung mga next parts na ikakabit natin. And before we end this vlog, of course, off-road natin ng konti ito. So guys, here is a clear test of the Raize. Tatry niya akyatin tong bangketa na to, which is pretty high. So let's see kung kaya. Nice, walang sayan. Sige. Kaya ba ng traction control? Kayang-kaya, walang problema. Wow.